In this video, we're going to take you through basic part design. At this point, you should have watched our other videos on things such as the handles, using catalogs, the user interface, the description of the seam, and most importantly, the tri-ball. Now that you've watched those, you'll be able to understand what we're doing when we're creating parts inside of IronCAD. So to begin, to create our new part, we're just simply going to go to the Shapes catalog and drag and drop in a cylinder. You'll see here that the cylinder is highlighted in cyan. That means it's selected as a part. If we click it again, we get a yellow highlight. This indicates that we have selected the actual feature. And once it's selected as a feature, we have the sizing handles. So to modify the shape, we simply select the handles that we want to modify. We'll select the diameter handle and put in a value of 60. And then we'll select the upper handle here and we'll put in a value of 100. And now we've got our updated shape. Now to continue on, we're just going to go in and drag and drop a block out of the catalog and drop it onto the top of the cylinder. You see there that we're getting the Smart Snap highlight, so we're going to drop it right onto the center, and then the block's going to be in the correct location. And again, using the handles, we're going to adjust our shape. So we start to pull on this handle here, and then taking this handle, we're going to hold down the Shift key and aim towards that edge so we snap right to the center of that circular face. And then we'll take this handle and put in a value of 100. And now we'll just pull the handle down. Again, holding the Shift key, we'll snap to the bottom of the cylinder. And then finally, the upper handle will have a value of 80. Now, if you remember from the handles video, we can use the Control key to select multiple handles to do a symmetric resize. So holding down the Control key, we select these two handles and then begin to adjust the size and put in a value of 50. Now we'd like to put on a chamfer onto the part, and to do that we simply click down until we get the green face selected and then click with the right mouse button and you'll get the menu that applies to faces. We're going to choose the command chamfer edges, and then we're going to, over in the left hand side, you have the property browser, and we're going to do a distance by distance chamfer, and we're just going to go in and put in the values that we want. We would like to have a 10 by 5 chamfer. If the values of the chamfer are in the wrong locations, you can quickly toggle the chamfer by selecting the toggle value command in the advanced options. With that being done, you click the green check mark and you have your chamfer. Now we'd like to add a blend to the model. And to do that, we're going to go to the feature ribbon bar and then click the blend edges tool. Now we're going to go into the model and we're going to click on this point here and this point here to apply the blends to those areas. And then moving along, we'll click on these two points here and here. And since these points have connected edges, all the edges connected to those points will get the blend command applied to them. Click the green check mark to apply the blend command. With the blend selected, now we can go back and easily edit it. I'll simply just click on the model once to get the blue highlight, which means I've got the part selected, then click on the blend again and I get the yellow highlight indicating that I've selected the blend, and you'll see here that the values have appeared, and to change the value of the blend I simply just click on one of the values and type in a new number. So here we're going to take this front blend and change it from 6 to 12. Now I'd like to actually create a custom shape with using a 2D sketch. And to do that, I'm going to go up to the feature ribbon bar and click on extrude. This will bring up the extrude command. The first thing you do after you've selected the extrude command is pick on the face where you want to create your extrude. And I'm actually just going to pick on this point right here, and the drawing plane will appear and the camera automatically aligns, so I'm looking straight at the grid. And what I'm going to do now is go to my sketch ribbon bar and begin drawing my profile. I'll select the Polyline tool, and starting at the XY position, I'm going to click the mouse, and then I'm going to go over to this area and click with the right mouse button. And when I click with the right mouse button, this dialog box appears. And this allows me to put in the length and the slope, and I'm going to put in 150 and 30, and then click OK. And then I'm just going to continue the profile using the left mouse button and finish doing the profile. Now I may want to edit the values of these lines, so if I select on this line here, you'll see that the dimensions appear, which can be edited. And I'm going to do two different edits here to show you the different behaviors. The first thing I'm going to do is change the value of the length of the line. And I'm going to leave, you see there's an option there that says maintain end conditions. By having maintain end conditions on, the end condition on both parts of the line is maintained. In other words, the angles are maintained. So that has actually made the profile pull out a little bit from the XY position. And that's fine. That's what we want. But let me show you what happens if we do it a different way. I'll go in and use the same command and turn that value off, and I'll say let's go to 65. Now the angle changes at the top. Now that our profile's done, we click Finish to finish the sketch. And this takes us back into the Extrude Wizard. And this is where you can set various extrude options. And what we're going to do is we're going to say through all for direction 1 and then through all for direction 2. And we're going to tell the shape that we're creating to remove material. With those selected, we hit the green check mark and we're done. Now to continue on, we'll go back to our drag and drop method here. We'll just drag and drop in an H cylinder into the design. And we want to set it to 10 units. Now you have many ways on how to position components inside of IronCAD. You can use the tri-ball or you can use things called smart dimensions. In this example, we use smart dimensions. So we'll go in and we're going to go to the annotation tool. And we'll select the smart dimension tool. And we're just going to snap from the center of that hole to that top face there. And then we're going to do it again from the center of the hole to this face here. With the dimensions placed, I just simply right-click on one of the dimensions and say edit all dimensions. And then I can put in precise values. See, now I'm going to do 60 by 20. And now the hole's in the correct place. Another option for positioning the hole would be to use the tri-ball. So let's show you that. First, we'll delete the hole that we've put in. We'll just drag and drop in another hole and set it to the same size of 10 units. Now, to position with the tri-ball, first we'll take the hole and move it down to that lower corner there. And then by locking the axis, we'll align the hole to the top of the top face. So now we know the hole is in the correct point in 3D space. And then from there, we'll just take the 2D plane and drag the hole down, and then we can put in the same values that we used earlier using the smart dimensions. So there's multiple ways in IronCAD as to how to position components. Finally, we want to shell out the part. And what we'll do is we'll pick the part with the cyan highlight. That means we've got it selected at the part level. With the part selected, we right-click and we choose the shell command. We can specify the thickness and we specify the faces that we want to be shelled out. Then click the green go button and we have our shelled shape. Now you may notice that the shell was applied last, but we may want to have that change. Well, it's simple. In IronCAD, we go to the scene browser and open up the part and you can see the various components that are inside the design. And to reorder, all we have to do is simply take the H cylinder and drag it after the shell and we get our updated shape. So it's just that simple. Inside of IronCAD, you have all these great tools that allow you to quickly and easily design inside of 3D. We hope this will help you get up to speed quickly with IronCAD. While you are evaluating, by all means, please feel free to contact us, your local reseller, for more tips and tricks. Thank you.